It's called sunny day flooding, and these large puddles have nothing to do with the rain. It's king tides, which are the highest tides of the year and occur in September, October, and November in Miami. They're twice a day, 3 days each month.
When the moon is on its closest distance to the Earth, therefore causing the tides to rise. So shore crest especially is particularly vulnerable, and as you're seeing here, some flooding impacts from the king tides coming up through the storm drainage system and coming from the Little River, impacting 10th Avenue.
The shore crest neighborhood is east of Biscayne Boulevard between Northeast 78th Street and Northeast 82nd Street, west of the 79th Street Bridge. The highest tide of the month of September has already passed. In some spots, the water on the street, shin deep for those collecting samples and measuring the depth of the water. Come October, experts estimate the water will be much higher, to the point where the grass won't even be visible at this park in Shorecrest, one of the most flood-prone areas in the city of Miami.
What makes this area particularly vulnerable to flooding, especially tidal flooding, is its location along the Little River and its adjacent location to the Biscayne Bay. So that combination of low elevations and location to the waterways makes it extremely susceptible to king tide flooding.
In August, the city's Office of Resilience and Sustainability had a community meeting with Shorecrest residents to talk about flood risks and action plans in their neighborhood during king tides.
It's really critical for us tonight to build a communication, to build a relationship between the city and all of you so that we can design solutions together.
79th Street and 10th Avenue Northeast, that's an area that was flooding quite frequently.
We want to have more of a real-time assessment of what king tide looks like in Shorecrest. So as such, we are partnering with our fire department, our emergency management section, and you can expect to see some drones flying above, surveying the area and doing aerial photography, so we can really assess the extent of king tide impacts in Shorecrest during the events.
Some king tide safety tips to keep in mind: don't walk or play in floodwater, as it may contain unseen hazards. If you come in contact with floodwater, be sure to clean your skin with soap and hot water. Don't drive through floodwaters, as it may be deeper than it appears. Don't park your vehicle in low-lying areas. Boaters should be aware that king tides can cause lower clearance levels than normal under fixed bridges. Properties in low-lying areas should take steps to mitigate the effects of tidal flooding, like using sandbags. And if you see standing water for more than 48 hours, please report it via 311. Once tides recede, remember to drain and cover to prevent mosquitoes.